book, and I've decided to do a merfolk scald recording. I'm not sure if I'll keep going with it, but I just wanted to test some things. This is still casual gameplay. I'm still experimenting. Right now my focus is on extended, but I learned quite a bit doing the Hillork fighter and Minotaur Berserker multiple runs and extended. Got some familiarity with those branches, which I did not have before, so that adjusted my opinion about the essential God branch progression for extended. But those species are pretty straightforward, low difficulty, very fault tolerant, so it may not have been very interesting to see my heterodox gameplay style on those species where a wide range of playstyles are going to succeed. In my opinion, all of the essential combos when played correctly are quite strong, but some are certainly, some species are still far more forgiving than others and have a lower skill floor. So I was just going to play, I started playing Merfolk without recording, casually, but I realized that it might actually be fun for me to record. So I'll just try it and see how it goes. The essential Merfolk background is Scald, which certainly fits the flavor of Shoals with all of the singing enchantresses and whatnot, but also fits the species characteristics very well. For one thing, a player merfolk wants to attract lots of monsters to whatever water features exist on the level, since he has a terrain advantage there. Anyway, you'll see how this essential build works, so I don't need to tell you all the theory about it in advance. The essential starting weapon is the falchion. MfSk often has to back up, and falchion is great for making retreating under pressure more viable, thanks to the extra riposte damage one gets for successful dodges, which is equal to about a third of the damage that the falchion does normally, if I recall correctly. So it's not trivial, and so that makes it a much more viable prospect to retreat, regain MP, and then re-engage even if the enemy is faster. Whereas otherwise, retreating just reduces your odds of winning the encounter. So it doesn't sound like a huge amount, you know, one third additional damage while retreating. But it changes tactical mobility while preserving win odds, which is important for avoiding adds, and also for, you know, a merfolk is lightly armored if played correctly, and so sometimes you'll just get unlucky and a hit will slip by, and then there's not much slip by the EV, and then there's not much AC to mitigate that hit, so you get some spiky damage in some fights, you just have to reset. And Merfolk's, and then the Scald background also tries to press its advantage while the buffs are up, and so kind of pushes to the edge a bit. Both the species and the background do so. So retreating is particularly important. Plus, it's a dex build. Well, it's a dex species. Stealth and dodging are very strong. Armor's -3, it's very weak. So he's a combatant, but he's a dex combatant. With +1 fighting versus -1 spellcasting. So falchion makes a lot of sense. And it's noticeably stronger than starting with the spear. Pole arms are still very important for a skull, a merfolk, and for a skull. But he's going to find pole arms, and they'll be his secondary weapon for various skulled antics. And working in watery terrain, etc. He'll get a spear and a halberd pretty quickly. But starting with the spear is the wrong move because he needs a weapon with high base damage to compensate for the fact that he doesn't have high strength. And so he'll have trouble piercing AC unless he's using a falchion. And infusion does not help pierce AC. It adds additional damage that's rolled separately against AC. So that's effectively making up for the falchion's relatively slower swing speed when not accounting for riposte. But it's not helping to pierce AC. So falchion does have a nice base damage. Okay, randomly select the name. So I've started Wamodier. 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 Anglicize him. You know what? I think I'll pronounce it Wamodier. It just sounds more flowing, like a merfolk name. Even though the English are the island and the French are the continental country, I feel. With his dex build and his long sword, or long blade emphasis, Wamodier feels right. Plus he's a charm rite, so certainly charms are something French. Don't need to pick up bolts and arrows due to the low aptitudes, but I will pick up sling ammunition. First thing to train is stealth. And secondly, dex is the primary, or dodging is the primary defense here. So the trouble is I'm not sure when I'll be able to push over the edge to the next EV step. So I'm a bit loath to invest heavily in dodging it right off the bat. So I think I'll just gain some long blade skill. Prefer to use the doors first. There's a pillar. Already got some stones to throw. what? Okay, that lizard is not very smart. I guess that was too stealthy for him. Well, that's not good. My infusion didn't. Okay, I guess I should have probably gone to the pillar. I thought I was being excessively cautious there. There's the noise. Yeah, Merfolk is spiky in his performance, so always have an open line of retreat is important. I think I should not have buried myself there. Although realistically, I don't think that exiting the dungeon in order to reset an early fight is should be counted as a loss. Guess what? It's just a tunnel. Why can't you go in and out? And that would alleviate some of the complaints about starting vaults. I mean, you can't scum it indefinitely. There should be some kind of accumulating penalty. Of course there is. Wasting your own time is a cost. Okay, I think I like this better. Whoops. Meant to throw another stone. But of course, Tab doesn't throw a stone when you're just hurling them. That's not good. Okay, so I could use this pillar, but that risks the slug interrupting the pillar dance. So I think I'm going to... that's not good. I guess I should have gone south. Too much open ground there. Okay, well, I mean, this would be a good time to just leave the dungeon. but that's not very fun, so... Well, that's my fault, isn't it? Because I should have retreated. All right, really need to kill this guy. No joy. Wow. Time for panic. Remove curse does nothing. Okay. Question is, how much stealth do I want? I think that is enough. Grab a level of throwing next. It's cheap. Okay, I think I've learned my lesson about my open spaces. Try to avoid the areas where there's been recent noise to let the density disperse, the monster density disperse a bit. Go. Curious. is. Throwing rocks with plus one slay. Not bad for this level. I'll level up Dex so that I can get my EV going by training dodging to primary. That'll also help my stealth, which are the two defensive primary skills of the Merfolk Scald. The meta for DCSS the current meta is to load up Merfolks with heavy armor, which is really a shame. You want to wear heavy armor, then play a hill orc. Or something with terrible stealth. And good armor skill. I like these long exterior corridors because even if Merfolk gets swarmed in here, he can Song of Slaying. See, most players would put on this ringmail immediately, but that is a mistake. That will kill his spells. Failure chance, which is more important than the AC, thanks to Shroud of Calubria. Okay, I don't like the open, so... Riposte also encourages casting during combat, melee range combat, since I suppose if a quarter of one's damage from melee happens even if one does not swing, which is good for a Scald who needs to keep Shroud of Illubria up for a certain effective HP bonus each cast. Important since he has low AC. So, Falchion helps make that transaction worthwhile, profitable. A trade-off, I should say. Okay. Precasting Shroud of Glubria is great, particularly when one has chunks. Did he shout? No. Stealth gives me the ability to scout out whether there are additional enemies coming, so I know whether it's a Song of Slaying type fight. Ouch. Okay. Shroud again. Great. This is an example of a situation where being able to riposte retreat is valuable. This kind of situation. In this particular one, I'm going to regen before I need to actually riposte. But you can see how the skull can kind of get caught. And need that riposte retreat for his escape. Cast Song of Slaying. Meant to use that bat to power up. Okay. Stealth showing its value. Thank you. That's it for D1. So, not the most expert starting vault, but after that, I think I play pretty well. Definitely not trying to be perfect right now, but it's fun to play well. So I'm not going to bother to try on that armor, so I know it'll be too heavy. Blind read these scrolls. Could enchant my leather armor, and yeah, based on the declining difficulty curve, I'll go ahead and do that. Anything that helps improve my odds of surviving to the next piece of gear is a good expenditure. Did want to charge that snake. And I still don't. I may be too banged up after the snake to even handle a frilled lizard, so. Oh, this is dangerous. It's infusion. And I lost the shroud. Put that back up. There we go. Infusion was valuable there for those extra ticks of damage to burn down the adder quickly. It's effectively a faster swing speed in terms of impact on AED. And the shroud helped out a lot, I'm sure. Let's see how many times it helped. Didn't help at all. Well, I can certainly kill that frilled lizard. Cut some chunks. It's about time to switch stairs. There's Zen, but I believe I want to leave my options. Yeah, I'm gonna go Jiva in the mid game. Yeah, because I want to transmute. He's a great transmuter. Merfolks are plus 3 aptitudes, so not gonna do Zen. Looking for Ellie early on. Then Fedas. For water and poison. Bat spotted me. That's okay, I can song of slaying it. There we go. Song's running out. Time to back off. Linked up with another stair. That's good. Whoops. Too bad. Okay. Well, I think I'll go around. Invisible hobgoblin? No, thank you. He's got a quarterstaff too. Tough guy. It's an advantage of making noise is enemy monsters get well equipped. They wake up and wander the level. What is he doing? He's throwing stones, yeah. Staves minus 2. No thanks. Good time to switch stairs. Let's see what I'm training. I think now would be a good time to. Bring dodging up to level 3. I don't know why I backed off for this. Whatever. Good. I may as well. Galubria now. Oops. Song's done. So I wasted that rat. Well, time to back off. I thought there was a worm. Yeah, there is. Shrouded infusion. That's all I can do. I do want to unlock that stair. But I'll need to gain my MP first. That's dangerous. That's very dangerous. Kobold. Yo. Dicey. All right, I've picked off one of them, so I don't need to push my luck. That's the floor. back after a short break, and I think this experiment of recording is going well. I think what happened was I played enough to where I was getting bored with the game, just playing without recording and commentating. And a game like this should be able to hold one's attention longer than I've played it. The issue is the difficulty can't be increased, and so it becomes a tedious grind. But commentating is a way to alleviate that. There's still moments where the difficulty spikes and I need to stop talking and start paying attention. So I need to develop that discipline to pause and think when I'm recording. The starting vault rush was an example of that. But I'm actually enjoying commentating now, whereas before I was trying to force it, I still had too many questions. Open-ended questions about game mechanics to really want to commentate. So, interesting lesson there. Don't try to force commentary. You'll reach the point where you're bored enough to want to do it eventually. I could consider training dodging again, since I am wearing light armor and completely depending on EV for my defenses. Almost completely 4AC is not nothing, but it's not much. And there's always the possibility of finding some water. So the step function, well, but if I find water, then my EV is not going to be an issue. Anyway, EV's at 13 now, and I'll try rushing it to 14, I suppose. Okay, a worm. Just want to overwhelm his regeneration, so infusion is the right spell for that purpose. We could risk the amulet, but I don't want harm. Nor do I want to get trained, since I'm a caster. Practicing the discipline of triple visitation in case of getting teleported or shafted. It's important to know where those stairs are. Be confident of winning this fight. without issue, so go ahead and Song of Slaying. I should be reading all the text. I'm sure that starting vault rush was not properly handled. I was too busy commentating to play it correctly. That is excellent. Book of Cantrips. Probably the best spell book I can find at this stage of the game. Maybe an Ice Elementalist would be better. Anyway, it's extremely good. I do want Ellie, but I could afford to use Animate Skeleton in the meantime. I could even consider skipping Ellie. Fedas, I doubt he allows Animate Skeleton. It's a corpse defiling, although there's some ambiguity because it's the bones and not the flesh, but bone meal. Plants love that. What is this? Crawl wiki. Oh, there it is. He's not telling me. I'm going to assume that Fedas won't allow it, so I probably should not memorize it, given how tight spell levels are. Certainly I want to memorize Confusing Touch, which is a great spell for a Scald. Extremely effective for these lower levels. Summoning would also be okay. I think his summoning aptitude is fine, but investing for summon small mammal is questionable, particularly when I'm spread thin as a hybrid. So we come back to that, but if I were going to be flexible with the god paths, then I could consider a non-essential god progression, such as Lugonu. Synergizes well with pole arms. Minus two necromancy, so it's not a great fit for Merfolk. Yeah, on a different species than the Animate Skeleton spell might be a reason to consider diverting from the good god's path, but for Merfolk, it's guaranteed that you want to go Fedas to take advantage of water control, the Merfolk's water advantage. So, and the minus necromancy doesn't make it very interesting to consider the evil route, so certainly not Kiku, but also in general, the draw of the evil route is in large part necromancy, which is a strong school to compensate for the loss of good gods. So I'm only going to take the Confusing Touch, which sounds underwhelming for how happy I was about Book of Cantrips, but that spell is amazing with Scald and Merfolk Pole Arms, so. Particularly at low levels when everything has low HD and is vulnerable. Now the priority is to train hexes. So I'll just forget about dodging. And might be a step function, so I think I want to rush to the next step, the next skill level, rather than balance. Focus it. Do not have a spear yet, need to find one soon. Full on chunks, it's a good time to switch stairs. This is a problem. That I have very few resources to deal with. The play is to confuse the Orc Sorcerer, Orc Wizard. ASAP. Then I can take my time. Luckily, I get it in the first cast. Unfortunately, he drops behind. So but at least line of fire is blocked, and I can safely use hasted. No, he's in this, so I need to disengage. He can confuse. But it won't matter. I'll still escape. go for link up. I'm okay on potions with the heal wounds. I want to find out what this amulet is. That is an amazing amulet. It was perfect synergy. Much more survivable now. That's why Merfolk has this falchion, is so that he can riposte reposition. So between the confusing touch and the acrobat amulet, this character is well established for D3. Those are two big breaks. Exploring the middle, which is not great. Up this one instead. Round two with the Orc Wizard. It's the one that I already met. I'm not in a position to fight him here. I can probably pull him. Maybe not. Switch stairs then. I should be picking up arrows for sticks to snakes. Foolish of me. Transmuter is the other good background for merfolk. Meeting this orc wizard out in the open is not a great idea. But I can probably dodge a lot of his attacks with Acrobat. So I guess I risk it. There it is. So bad. Oops. Should have kept going and gotten to here. Oh, he hit me through my EV. There we go. Through my Acrobat EV. Okay. Should have confused him again, reconfused him earlier. I guess I technically red zone there. Need to slow it down. Yeah, it was a dangerous combat. I should have taken it a lot slower. Okay, D3 is done. Onwards to D4. There's an ossuary, which means particularly on this awkward D3, I don't have time to triple visit. At least until I get a idea of, oh, there it is. Okay. Can afford to be a bit more cautious. Explore the area. The song didn't proc. Oh. Means I don't need to worry about this. The song miscast. A staff. I'm curious. Staff of Death. Maybe it'll be useful. Don't need to free up space in my inventory. Spectral weapon would be nice to have. That's a higher priority than training dodging, but spell casting is already at primary, so. Still, I could train spell casting instead of fighting. Slowed by a bog mummy immediately. He also throws frost. Watery terrain is an advantage. Icy clouds would be a problem. It's one turn. Confusing touch. Shroud. Not good. Time to go. I think that went as well as it could have. I don't think there was a way to rescue that. At least I didn't spend any resources. There's my trident, and a lone orc. Confusing touch candidate. due to the armor he was wearing. Time to train pole arms. Makes polearm makes confusing touch much more efficient. Here we go. Another invis wizard. Two confusing touches did the trick. I think that was pretty well handled. There was some risk that he started casting hard at me, but on the other hand, I had a +1 sleigh. to capitalize on. Keep leveling decks. The decks to int ratio should be about 1.5 to 1, if I recall correctly. I did have a teleport and a acrobat amulet and a heal wounds, so. You can handle the rest of this pack. Actually, ringmail might not be too much to wear. Now that I got remove curse, I was thinking scale mail is definitely too heavy, but ringmail. That's much more reasonable. And then I can also train armor, which will help a bit. To switch stairs. Hello. Wearing that plate armor would be a total rookie error. Although I did miss putting on that ringmail. Fourth floor or two. Well, it's not accurate to call it a rookie error, since some of the most experienced players in the game would do something like that, but it's a common error, prevailing wisdom error. There's my spear, and I do have remove curse, so go ahead and check that out. Good, now I can apply Confusing Touch with the spear and then punish with the trident. Phantom. Did not come with This is a very nice bookshop. Should be fine to engage this phantom, thanks to the Acrobat amulet. There we go, time to punish. Actually, I should have a dagger for applying confusing touch. Always need to be willing to retreat as a merfolk. Sometimes the EV just puts you down, and that's okay. Okay, so I can apply. Don't need to actually train daggers just to apply confusing touch. Maybe he's at range, so use the trident, or the spear instead. Confused? He blinks anyway. Oh, because he blinks on hit. That's annoying. Well, refresh. Got me again. Almost down. I think I can finish this. Falchion? Okay, maybe not. With stones. They definitely live up to their annoying reputation. Still, on a less capable character, they can burn up rations, which didn't happen. Spell casting is high enough. Fighting. And I can get spectral weapon going. No point yet though. No brilliance. That orc might have been handy for handling the phantom. Maybe I should have used him for a plus one slay. Save a lot of time. What the? Okay. Alright, how do I want to handle this? Confusion, I think. Yep. Nice riposte. Nice. So Okawaru, that's probably Might, I would imagine. nifty little vault. Total defenses, whereas 17 and better spells. Yeah, so the GDR doesn't really matter at this low AC, so I'm still better off with the leather armor. I'd forgotten that I enchanted it. Ouch. Probably have to retreat again. Really does not want to cast Confusing Touch. There we go. And I already got it. He's confused. So we can turn invisible even when he's confused. That's annoying. At least I think that's what happened. Spectral Weapon is getting there. EV is up to 14, so a training dodge was a good call. Give stealth another level. Polos as well. Without confusing touch, I'd have been doing that with infusion, which would also work. Maybe even be less annoying, who knows. Too well. Hopefully they sting each other. There we go, two confuses into him. Forgot to triple visit. This again. I should stack up confuses, that's what I'm doing wrong. Thank you. is they're worth a lot of XP. Relatively. Okay, fighting leveled up. Tempted to find out how that confusion duration enchantment works. Turn on wizard mode and track that. When I get an opportunity, see whether I'm stacking it correctly. That went well. Oh, right. I wanted to find out how the enchantment works, so... Inspect this guy. There it is. 155. And it has tiers. So I suspect it decays the same way that... That poison does. Yeah, that was two turns. Now it's at 135. So what I need to do is space out the applications and so it's about time to apply again. Not confused him a second time, and his duration is bumped back up. Yeah, if I increase it more, just for science, I'll increase it again. Now it's at 231. It should go up in tiers. Just make her really confused. Oh, crap. That's at 390. I'm not getting the tier behavior, but I suspect that there's a non-linear degradation. Okay, first things first, shroud. Song. Come on, song. Oop. Well. He's still confused. Let's see if I can get the kill. Yeah. Okay, so maybe it does just stack up, and the trouble is that sometimes now I've really got a wisdom of this, I have to know. Something, yeah, how about a troll with a shield would be good. And set all skills to max. Clear everything. Learn the confusing touch spell. And the rate at which Confusing Touch decays is dependent on hit dice, so for example, a Phantom is a bad choice, but how about a Ogre? How about an Edmund? Okay, he's at 50, so it's just not much duration. If I apply it again. Still under 100, whereas if it's an iguana. He's at 100. Now he's at 198. Wait a turn. 188. Wait two turns. 68. Six turns. 108. Yeah, so the zero to the left of the colon isn't getting used. Just keep stacking duration. So the rule is stack up as much duration as you think it's going to take, and then just kill him. It doesn't work like poison. You don't have to space out applications. That explains why Confusing Touch was overwhelming. I was using it wrong. Underwhelming. Is with, oh, ring now. Okay. It's annoying that the first sighting message doesn't describe their armor as well as their weaponry. And the old pack, deal with that later. Howler. Priority is to disable. figure two is enough for him. I line of sighted him and then pulled him over here because his loud noise is going to have trouble propagating from there. And he won't howl when he can't see me. So it's preventing him from howling is only one way to prevent the rest of the map from being alerted. Very low HD on that worker ant, so on the zombie rather, so should be easy to confuse. Should have confused him twice. Okay, an adder. Definitely want Shroud up. And then confuse. Take a step back. Because he's fast, so I want him trapped in the corridor. I'll go ahead and confuse him twice, please. Stop miscasting. Okay, that ought to do it. And it did. I'm liking the corrected confusing touch tactics. Worker ant is basically the same fight. Should have waited for my MP to recharge. That's two. Probably going to need another one. Now. Very nice. Recharge the MP. Spectral weapon is available now. Can get another level in hexes. Depending on it heavily with confusing touch, so it's worth it. Having the null right in my face prevents his buddies from netting me. Looks like we lost one. Shroud. Confuse. There he is. Good job. Reconfuse. I could do Song of Slang, but oh, I do have chunks. It's just overkill, though. To draw the nets by. Should have kept him confused and have him kill this guy too. Now I need to acrobat to dodge the nets. Okay, he's out. Got some throwing nets. Can upgrade throwing. Although, no, I don't think I'll put another skill point in there yet for two nets. They're pretty accurate anyway. Should find Ellie here. Skull, a merfolk skull does a lot of running away, which synergizes with divine protection. I avoid charging for the temple for the reason that it's a good way to get ambushed by, for example, that null pack. Which I was much better off meeting in corridors than getting netted twice. Out in the open. Howler Monkey, and where he is not a problem. So, Shroud. Confuse. My short blades are undertrained. Give him another confuse. That should be enough. Oh, maybe he needs another one. He stayed away for a while. Confused again. There we go. interesting choice. Armor or resistances? I think I'll default to armor and then swap if I have a reason to. Because armor synergizes with Shroud of Bulubria. Prevent adds. He's confused. Maybe put one more in to be safe. And now I can finish. Looks like a vault, so I'm just going to back out. Okay, here's some more gnolls. Definitely want to have Acrobat up for any nets. MP's a little low. Don't like that. Here they come. Need to be aware of the nets. Keep the Acrobat up. He might have a net. He does not. Okay, I think I'm okay. I'm not okay. This guy's not very observant. That was dangerous. He might have had a nut, but he doesn't. good. Halberds instead of to use to punish instead of the trident. Halberd is extremely efficient. Now I've got the whole confusing touch combo put together. The halberd finisher. It might have been the null pack up there, awakened by. Yep. By Howler. That's not good. Clearly, I need to retreat to the stair. He can do a lot of smiting from there. About the wizard. Fusion. No, it's not going to work. Too risky. It might well have worked, but the odds of it not working were too high. Halberd is great. not sure whether that was worth it. Probably not, to confuse that low-level critter. Well, I was worried this would be a tough vault, but in reality, the tough stuff is behind. He's got a lot of HP, so I'll give him two confuses. Nice. Piece of cake. And another one. Now I need to worry about where those orcs are. Probably still contained there. Which makes them hard to dig out. Given that those orcs have two wizards, I'll get my temperature resistances going. Okay. Here's crazy youth. Can't use that chaos weapon yet. And I don't have a reliable way to put him down either. Should have memorized Spectral Weapon a while ago. Didn't need it, thanks to Confusing Touch. So I've got Orcs loose. A dangerous pack. Now I've got two wizards to deal with, but I'm reasonably powered up. And I need to decide what to level up. I think that pole arms is starting to play a very prominent role in my tactics. And I suppose I could level up dodging. Probably want to keep confusing these wizards. Oh, crap. Maybe they'll hurt each other. Yeah, they are. Good. Bring my spectral weapon back. Okay. Still into this guy. Not sure why he's wandering around, but... Well, maybe it's because I confused him. But he's still invis. Well, that's not what I want. So I'm just gonna use my weapon as cover and reset. Another for good measure, and that'll do. Right, I think I demonstrated some valuable tactical lessons, even though there were some faults I haven't fully adapted to commentating, but I'm improving. I think it's not possible within reach for me to play the way I want to while commentating. And this is a good stopping point for the video, I think. Go back to AC. Blind red magic mapping. Now there's no need to take the risk of triple visitation. So yeah, that's the start of D6, and I'll call it there. I think the character is well established. About to get his first pip of LA piety. Soon he'll be able to do lesser healing, so that'll make him even more survivable as he draws out fights with Acrobat and Confusing Touch and so forth. And that is how the essential Merfolk Scald is played. Thank you for watching.